I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. You know that you have eternal life, so that you will believe in the name of the Son of God, so that people should no more live in confusion, in doubt. You don't die without God. Jesus denied some practices of the old because they have never been God's command. God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Why did Jesus Christ refuse certain verses of the Bible? Because those verses of the Bible, darkness. When you look at Jude 9, you see that the enemy contend with archangel. Satan contend with an archangel, Michael, because he wanted the soul of Moses. The reason being that he had been working with Moses, but Moses was not aware of the activities of the enemy over his life. So he came after his death now to claim the soul because he thought it belonged to him. But God was using Moses. Moses belongs to God because he was a servant of God. The devil disguised himself as an angel of light in order to minister certain verses of the law which men were following them. We shall see how God did not appreciate the sacrifices and the offerings of the fathers of the old because they were not the desire of God. The devil disguised himself as an angel of light, and his ministration is in the Bible. When you lie, saving for a curse of fornication, caused her to commit adultery, and whosoever shall marry her that is divorced committed adultery. This is where we have been taught that if you want to divorce your wife, you write the divorcement letter and you can send her away. But Jesus Christ is telling us that what God has put together, let no man put asunder. Again, ye have heard that it had been said by them of old time, thou shalt not forswear thyself, but shalt perform unto the Lord thine oath. But I say unto you, swear not at all, neither by heaven, for it is God's throne, nor by the earth, for it is footstool, neither by Jerusalem, for it is the city of the great king. Neither shalt thou swear by the head, because thou canst not make one hair white or black. But let your communication be yes, yes, and if no, let it be no. For whatsoever is more than this cometh of evil. You have heard that it had been said, thou shalt love thy enemy and hate thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thy enemy. But I say unto you, love your enemy, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your father. That you may be the children of your father, which shows that if you were doing the contrary, that say love your neighbor and hate your enemy, then you were not the children of your father. You have adopted another father, like the prodigal son left his father and went to a far country. It shows that there he had a different father, but it was good for him because he regained his mindset. He came to himself, he recovered himself and came back to his father. And because of the love that the father had for the son, he took him back. So he says here that, so that you will be the children of your father which is in heaven. For he maketh his son to rise on the evil and on the good. On the evil and on the good. And sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. For if ye love them which love you, what reward have ye? Do not even the publican do same? And if ye salute your brethren only, what do ye more than others? Do not even the publican so? Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father which is in heaven is perfect. So these are 3 points out of many which Jesus Christ has counseled some of the commandments and the verses which were given to us from the Bible, which show that these commandments were not the word of God, will never benefit the second resurrection into eternal salvation. So he that is still living in death today, if now your mortal body goes now to the soil, it is the end time. There's no more time for you to repent and then regain the Spirit of God. So I will pray that let your eyes of understanding be enlightened as you live in the grace of God. So continue to worship and to fellowship and to read the Bible, not believing in men, believe in the Word, looking what the Word has said, abiding in and walking into the commandments of God. See you next time.